Hello and welcome back. In this video, we'll briefly take a look at data preparation and then we'll create a model. If you want to follow along, you can download the data file and import it. The videos Importing Data and Data Loading Process videos will both show you how it is done. We'll start by retrieving the data from our repository. Click on the Data directory, highlight your customer data, and drag it over like so. Before we actually build a model, we want to inspect our data for issues and to see if we need to do any further preparation. So click on the Output port of the operator and drag a connection to the Results port of the Process panel. Click the port to establish the connection and come over to your Run Process button and run it. We've seen this result before, but let's talk a little bit more about it now to understand what we need to do to build a decision tree. As we talked about before, each row in your data set is called an example in RapidMiner, and each column is called an attribute. You see the churn attribute here? It's green. Well, that means it's a special attribute. It's a label. But what does label mean? The term label is just a fancy name to tell any advanced algorithm that this is the attribute of interest. If you have sharp eyes, you'll see that there's some question marks in our label. Those are rows or examples where we don't know if this person belongs in the loyal bucket or churn bucket. These may be new customers that we've just got, and now we want to be able to find out where do they belong, or are they loyal or are they churn? And if they are churn, we might want to take some preemptive actions to try to keep them. A lot of times, advanced algorithms can't handle missing values. So what we're going to do today is we're going to filter out all the examples with missing information, and then we build a decision tree from the prepared data. And how do we do that? Well, we'll use one of RapidMiner's advanced ETL, also known as extract, transform, and load operators. So let's go back to the design view. Let's search for an operator called filter examples. Highlight it and drag it over, and when you see the connection get thick, drop it. One thing you should know, RapidMiner is pretty smart about wiring operators together, but sometimes you may want to have a little bit more control over it. So feel free to hover over the port, right-click, and then disconnect it if you don't want it. In this case, we will leave it. To continue, let's click on Filter Examples, and let's see the parameters of the operator to filter out all those examples with missing values. Navigate to the right to your Parameters panel, click on Add Filters, and it gives you a nice wizard. You can see here that it automatically populated gender, but we don't want gender. We want to filter on churn. So pull down this menu, select the churn, and hover over to the conditions. Pull them down, scroll down to Is Not Missing. So what we're doing here is we're telling RapidMiner to filter out all the examples which have a question mark in our churn attribute. Let's hit OK, and let's hit the Run Process button. Great, I don't see any more question marks. So are we ready? No, we just filtered the example set because we saw there were some missing values in the first few displayed examples of our label. To make sure we've done the filtering correctly and there are no red flags in the other attributes either, let's look at the statistics RapidMiner has helpfully calculated for us. Click on Statistics. You can see here that there are zero missing in all the attributes. Now we're ready to build a decision tree. Great, so let's go back to our design view and go back to our operator panel to look for a decision tree modeler. Highlight it, drag it over, and drop it on the connection. But before we hit run our new process, let's save all our work. Let's expand the process directory. We see we have 01 import customer data, so let's call this 02 build decision tree. Let's save it by highlighting the process directory, right-clicking, and select store process here. And we will give the process the name 02 to build decision tree, and now we're ready to run it. Okay, in this decision tree, we see that the most important variable to split on is gender. In case you want to know how this first split attribute is identified by a decision tree algorithm, then check out the very entertaining decision tree episode of 5 Minutes with Ingo in our YouTube channel, featuring also our chief furry officer. But now back to our result view. We see here that most of our customers are loyal if they are of the gender male, but what would we expect according to this tree if you would be a new customer, if you are, let's say, a female named Annie, who is 39 years old, and may have last interacted with us a month ago? Let's see how she would be classified according to this tree. Gender, Annie is female. She's not older than 89, but she is younger than 89. But then she's older than 30.5, so she's in this branch. So she's likely a churn candidate. Now, in contrast, if Annie was younger than 30, and since she has interacted with us only a month ago, we would want to know what payment method she used to predict her next action. If she used her credit card, we would likely have a loyal customer in her. The thickness of the colored bar indicates out of how many examples the branch is made. If you want to see some of the numeric information, you can look at the description tab. Let's click on that, and here we see that the branch which we would use to classify our 30-year-old and credit card using Annie has 87 examples, out of which 73 are loyal and 14 are churn. Congratulations, you built and reviewed your first decision tree model. Thank you very much for watching.